since we've had the Hustler, we're probably saving about 20% wastage compared to the other bale feeder, just from it not putting it in the path of the wheels, especially when it's muddy and wet. So we're getting a lot better feed efficiency from it. And being it fed out nicely and teasing the bale apart, the cows don't trample it into the ground as much either. Hi, I'm Ben Mayo. I farm 205 hectares in South Rhino in northern Tasmania. We milk 500 cows at our dairy here, spring calving and autumn calving, so it's a split calving herd. And the herd's a mixture of Frisians and crossbreds. We don't have much irrigation on this farm. We're only about 40% irrigated and we're split calving. So we're feeding the cows a lot through winter. So we feed out between 1,000 and 1,500 bales a season, depending on each season and how it goes. So originally we had an older bale feeder and we used to get a lot of feed wastage with it, where it'd feed the silage out in the path of the wheels and just trample it into the mud, especially in winter. So we started looking at other options, got talking to our dealer, and they recommended we go down the Hustler path, just because there's a lot less wastage with their feeders. We settled on the X5000 chainless feeder, handles squares and rounds, which gives us a lot of options for buying and feed if we need to, and gives us the option of round or square bale silage on the farm. We don't do any pit silage here, just bales for ease of handling and carting about. With its ability to carry two bales at once, it saved a lot of time going to and fro the paddocks. The way it feeds the bale out and teases it apart, the cows waste a lot less, so then, you know, ideally we'll be feeding less bales this season due to less wastage. It's very easy to maintain, there's not many moving parts, which is good. Very easy to access grease points, so it's simply a case of running a bit of grease around once a week and no problems at all. We've been very happy with the job it's done.